Well, staying in the state's south, and residents at Sussex Inlet are dreading another bout of hot, windy days and dangerous fire conditions. They escaped the onslaught of yesterday's blaze, but many people still spent the night in evacuation centres. Here's John Hill.
Firefighters were able to bring the blaze west of Sussex Inlet under control today. It was a different story last night, with a fierce westerly wind driving the fire towards the town. The threat eased as a subtly changed shifted the fire front away from homes. That was a relief for many residents and holidaymakers who had spent the night at evacuation centres.
It was very golden looking. You could see it was quite a ways away, but because the wind was blowing in our direction, it looked extremely severe.
We had a lady come over from next door and say the fire's coming through, and to meet at the RSL. So we chucked a couple of things in the car and took off.
Evacuees brought their pet animals to the local RSL club to keep them safe too.
It was very frightening not knowing what was going, but we felt very safe here, very well looked after.
Meals were provided by the Salvation Army. With roads blocked, many relied unexpectedly on the salvos. Matt Green stayed on his farm to defend his home and look after his animals.
I don't think there's any question we would have got it if the westerly continued. I think it was fortunate that, and great work by the RFS, that they contained it to a certain degree on the highway and the power lines.
Today, Federal Opposition Leader and Rural Fire Service volunteer Tony Abbott was helping to douse the flames. This is the eastern containment line of the fire, just a few kilometres from Sussex Inlet. Firefighters are working hard to knock down this blaze ahead of more hot weather due on Friday. Firefighters say unless they can stop new outbreaks, the blaze could reignite and threaten Sussex Inlet again. John Hill, 10 News.